I'll start with one very short presentation about our excavations in the Eastern Rhodopes in the last few years. Over the past 20 years, a number of active archaeological excavations have been carried out in the region of the Eastern Rhodopes. The studies of Professor Ovcharov, my studies, some of the field studies led to accumulation of a huge amount of new data on the development of the so-called rock culture in this region of ancient Thrace. This is one of the areas in today's Bulgaria which have the most developed archaeological complexes cut entirely in the rocks. Chronology in the appearance, development and distribution of these strong traditions in rock processing is wide. It dates back to the Bronze Age in the second millennium before Christ, that continues without interruption until the end of Antiquity, 7th century after that. Thus, for then 2 millennia, in the region of Eastern Rhodopes, complexes have been built in the rocks, like sanctuaries, rock niches, crevices, altars, but also reservoirs, water supply systems, fortresses, fence walls, and whole rock buildings. For example, at archaeological sites, Tatul and Angel Voyvoda, here in point 1 and point 2, have been excavated some of the most interesting rock tombs in Bulgaria. On the largest site, Perperikon, here in the number 3, a whole rock city is built in the late Roman times with fortress walls of several zones, reservoir tanks, rock buildings and streets, temples and public buildings, even entire church complexes. The purpose of this short presentation is to present this new field data, which completely changed our view of this Thracian region during the transition from prehistoric times to antiquity. The first archaeological excavation that we can present here is in the region of Haskovo, near to the village of Angel Voyvoda. This is my excavations since 2016. This is the site placed on the top of the hill, perfectly visible from almost all directions, like here. Materials and structures were localized dating to the late Bronze Age, the early Iron Age in the Hellenistic period and the Roman Imperial period, even in the late Antiquity. The top of the site is a fortress, fortified area from late Antiquity, from the 4th to 6th century, an earlier Thracian sanctuary dating probably to the period from the late Bronze Age to the Roman Imperial period. A rock cut tomb, similar to sarcophagus-like chamber in Tatul, was cut in the top of the hill. Here the rock cut tomb. The burial bed is situated under the sky on the most prominent rock dominating the vicinity. It is situated on the highest protruding rock at about 615 meters above sea level. At present, this is the only close analog to the upper tomb chamber from the double sarcophagus found in Tatul a few years ago. It is aligned in the west-east direction. Here, the well-preserved tomb chamber measuring 1.80 meters in length and 40-60 centimeters in width, but can be seen in the uppermost section of surviving rock. Some of the other substantial elements from the tomb complex are as follows: the big furrow-hewn rock roughly in the rock, starting from the chamber on the top and discerning, excuse me, here. Starting from the top, it's descending directly down to the slope, down to the surface, and three rock step races, like here. These faces are rather rough. They are quite similar to the steps noted in Tatul. In this zone of Angel Voyvoda, there is also a clear visible rock stratigraphy. In the uppermost section of the rock formation, where the tomb is, the furrows and the rock steps have survived. They were made with tools which were definitely much smaller and less efficient in terms of rock removal capacity than the ones used during the Roman period. Larger races can be noticed at the step below this uppermost section of the rock, similar to the ones in Tatul, the big site, in Perperikon on the southern slope of the site, and in Philippi, where the sanctuaries of Silvanus were published. And the complexes mentioned in this foregoing sentence were dated to the Hellenistic and Roman periods. This is how the perfectly preserved and fairly interesting rock stratigraphy near Angel Voyvoda made it possible to compare cuts from at least three different periods. The ones related to the tomb, which are probably from the late Bronze Age and early Iron Age, the ones in the middle of the rock, which are probably from Hellenistic and Roman imperial period, and the lowermost ones, which are undoubtedly related to the church from the late antiquity and fortification wall of the site from the 4th to 6th century. Yes, here is the oldest rock cuts. Next complex, which rock structures in Angel Voyvoda shows, called rock sacrificial altar and furrows. This second monument is not like sacrificial altar, placed in the westernmost part of the high rock structure, though initially this Thracian rock structure was identified as sacrificial altar, altar with a possible round form, like here, seems to be definitely a more precise term. In the middle of the structure, there is a hole where the wooden pillars and other elements used in the rituals must have been placed. The third rock cut structure in Angel Voyvoda, well known like a huge share of Anna, during the current archaeological campaign, which ended literally during the preceding weeks, we managed to find again the location of this previous identified Sherpana at the site. It's interesting to know what is this rock structure as a matter of fact. Quite a few Sherpanas have been unearthed in Eastern Rhodopes, which have no reliable dating to or identified function. The structure near Angel Voyvoda is perhaps the best example that these rock basins were not only probably for grape stomping and wine making. The structure here is nearly 5.5 meters long, however in width it's small, about 56 centimeters. The main point of it is that the rock structure is not deep enough, barely 20-25 centimeters, and it does not make any sense for this shallow rock basin to have been used for a grape stomping, nor was this virtually double. The fourth structure in Angel Voyvoda is so-called huge rock altar. Now it's exactly this monument that we can identify both in terms of function and type of structure. Moreover, there are clues as to its chronology too. The altar near Angel Voyvoda is in the shape of a regular circle closed by a high verge. Here in the side view. Based on the at least the latest studies of Perperikon, we can mention that similar rock altars were found and documented there during the period 2009-2011. They are also in the form of circle, and the cut areas have a similar diameter of about 180 meter, 2000 meter, and they have a high verge also. We found very often cult materials and cultural levels from early Iron Age around this type of altars. The fifth rock cut complex in Angel Voyvoda is a niche complex on the eastern slope of the site. When commenting on the strong, stable tradition in the cult practices of Thracian tribes, perhaps the most astonishing and enigmatic subject of investigation are the Thracian rock niches. The Angel Voyvoda sanctuary ranks among the richest rock niches complexes. Currently, we have registered over 50 of them in various areas of the hill, but surely there must be any others as well. They are scattered at different locations. Two rock formations surrounding the niches were found at the top of the Hsara ridge, but the biggest rock chunk is at the foot of the eastern slope. There are 17 niches cut in different rock sites of the rock chunk. Angel Voyvoda niches stand out among the other rock niches in the Rhodopes in two aspects. Firstly, they were cut at low height and are fairly easy accessible. Secondly, the dimensions of the niches are huge. They are about 70-80 centimeters in height and were cut deep into the rock. Maybe some of them are unfinished also, it's visible here on the side. Some of them were cut vertically inside the rock, others have an almost spherical ceiling, but above all of them were cut with heavy-duty iron tools with a coarse surface, a fact I believe is undisputable on the basis of evident traces left on the rock, and especially the precise and straight edges of their stems. Curiously, the niche seems to be cut at random. There are also straight rows. The niches are definitely arranged in groups on tools and in trees. Here is the sixth rock cut complex on Angel Voyvoda. Two passages with the niches from the south slope of the sanctuary. Another important fact that meets an eye in Angel Voyvoda sanctuary is that the rock niches are almost invariably found close to the passageways, like here. Those two parallel passageways were found on the southern slope. Here they are situated between the high rock formations, but their sites were certainly finalized additionally with tools. During all of periods, the place was in use. This was the case during the Roman period and the late antiquity, judging the fortification walls and possibly by a tower that were constructed here on the same passageways. Here is the two levels of the fortification tower from late antiquity, covered the rock cut niches very well visible in the western side. There are niches preserved on the southernmost side of the passageways, which were not destroyed by Roman and late antiquity fortification works. No layers from the late Bronze and early Iron Age found here, localized in these passageways, but materials probably are removed in the later periods. From this period, yeah, here are the niches from the passageways, saved from the Roman and late antiquity period. From earlier periods, we have plenty of materials, like ceramic from late Bronze Age, early Iron. The next very important archaeological site in the Eastern Rhodopes excavated in the last few years in the East Thracian sanctuary near Tatul. The site was mentioned and studied four decades ago by Professor Venedikov and archaeologist from Kerjali, Ivan Balkanski. It is famous with his huge rock cut tomb built over the top of the hill. The tomb complex is made by two chambers, upper under the sky, and the main chamber in the front of the complex. Here, like in Angel Voyvoda, we have all the other elements from Thracian rock cut sanctuaries. Cut niches, terraces in front of the main entrance of the sanctuary, passageways, steps like here. All of them are cut entirely in the rock. Also, we have so much materials like a clay altar with floral ornamentation found by our colleague Balkanski in 76th year, and one very huge rock cut altar with a round form. In the same situation, we could see on the biggest rock site in the Rhodopes, so-called site of Perperikon, the Byzantine fortress with so much earlier periods. There are more than 50 rock cut structures at Perperikon site. It's very big to explain here, but I'll show only a few sites to present the site. Yes, because of huge number, I'll summarize here main complex. All rock cut architectural buildings and altars. The so-called rock cut palace, called by Professor Venedikov 30 years ago, placed on the southern slope and contains more than 30 premises, in the western site, in the western wing of the of this structure. They believe here are the domestic part of the building. On the central part, we have two courtyards with the streets, and two passages led to the main part of the complex. And in the eastern, in the most western wing of the complex, are the so-called cult part of the rock structures. Here with the huge rock altar with number one, the grave complex, like a mausoleum with hippogeum part. With number two, and the rock sanctuary, probably it is a little sanctuary of Mitra from the 3rd or 4th century after date, in place in the westernmost part, in the number 3 here on the slide. In conclusion, we must note that the investigations of this Thracian rock cut complexes in the Eastern Rhodopes, like in these three sites shown here, Angel Voyvoda, Tatul and Perperikon, which has started from a purely archaeological point of view in the last few years, these new excavations could deliver many new data about the cult practices and facilities in the Eastern Rhodopes. The study of the rock niches, rock tombs, passageways, altars and other formations, like for instance the dolmen in the region, should be continued with a program of comprehensive and accurate graphic documentation and mapping, not done yet. Especially rewarding would be the cross-sections on the facilities and the methods applied to structure these complexes, such more often that not the lack of cultural layer with finds prevents this precise investigation both in terms of function and chronology. On the basis of accurate documentation, we could obtain valuable information that can be used in comparative analysis with the monuments from the neighborhood regions like in northern Greece, in western Anatolia, and from the islands, as we saw here in Limnos, from the other sanctuaries, demonstrating the flourishing rock culture in the Rhodope and North Aegean region from prehistory and all antiquity period. So, thank you for your attention.